Hello, this is Delai. Welcome on board again this week as we continue our conversation on brand building. Yet last week, we spoke about what brand is and how it is critical that when you go through the growth phase, you start laying the foundation for your brand. But this week, I want to take you through a quick six-step process or things that you need to know when it comes to brand building. I insinuated the word process just now because you cannot build your brand like you are cooking something through a pressure cooker. It is a process. It takes time. It takes years. When you see a very successful brand that is now recognized and that is now that the market is attached to, it didn't just happen overnight. The question is, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with the first step. When are you going to take that your own first step? That is exactly why we are here, to let you know what those steps are and then to guide you on how to take them. So what is the very first step you need to take when it comes to brand building? The very first one is, you must know who your customers are. You know, every now and then we keep coming back to this point. It is not just enough for you to design something that you are trying to sell to the market. You are better off if you are able to find what the market wants and you are able to provide it. Whether it's a product, whether it's a service, or even whether it is a dream. Whatever the market wants, if you can find that and provide it, you're on your way to building a successful brand. So the first thing you must know now is, for this product, for this solution, for this service, who are my customers? What do I know about them? What are their demographic information? What are their psychographic information? What are their lifestyles? What is their worldview? The more you know about your customers, the easier it is for you to be able to build a brand that can connect with them. If you do not know your customer, and then you are just sitting in the dark and trying to design an exciting brand and an exciting brand communication, there will be a disconnect. Because imagine you are providing a commodity that is FMCG, fast-moving consumer goods, that is just everywhere manufactured by different people. And then you are positioning your brand as if it's a brand that speaks to the elites, simply because you have the money to invest in the brand development. You will have a disconnect. So remember what I said last week? Brand experience is the totality of the customers of your communication and the customer experience. The two must go together. How you sell, where you sell, when you sell, what language you sell in, what kind of people you hire to sell, what kind of place you sell in, and the kind of communication you use, the channel you use, is an integrated process. The clearer you are about who your customers are, the higher your chances of being able to build a successful, enduring brand. Make that number one. Number two would then be to define your brand. Last week I mentioned the Apple brand. Apple, as from the beginning, it's not just now. Steve Jobs wanted to build a sexy laptop, a sexy desktop, something unusual. He was very deliberate from the beginning as to the definition of the brand. And slowly, it has now grown to become a lifestyle brand. And that is the only reason why the customers are willing to pay such premium for a product that should actually be a commodity. Somebody said that Apple is getting the margin of a Lamborghini or a Ferrari, and it is getting the volume of a commodity. And that tells you why they are a $1 trillion company. So, you need to define your brand. What is it? Remember, you are to know who your customers are, then define your brand in a manner that speaks to them. Number three, you need to then look around you in the market and ensure that you don't just get lost with everybody. This is called differentiation. You must be able to differentiate your brand. Everybody's manufacturing milk. Everybody's manufacturing handsets. Everybody's manufacturing tissue paper. How will yours be different? What are the unique selling points that you are pushing? What is that thing that you are trying to do better than competition? What is that gap that you are trying to fill? Like we said in the beginning of this series, what is that problem that you are trying to sell? The clearer you are about who your customers are, and the clearer the definition of your brand, then the easier it is for you to differentiate yourself in the market. The more differentiated you are, the more visible your brand is. So you need to be sure that you are well aware of what your unique selling points are and then project them very powerfully so that it can stand you apart and you can draw the customers to yourself. That is point number three. Now, point number four, you need to then find the right brand elements that helps you to communicate all these things that you have done. The customers you are trying to reach, the definition for your brand, the differentiation you are trying to make, you must be able to crystallize this into a few set of elements. Elements like logos, like colors, like fonts, like images, like payoff line. They must be deliberately crafted. We are happy to provide you with this service should you require it. But if you can find the brand elements, how you arrange this, how you arrange that, how you mix this, how you mix that, your colors, the image you use, the combination of text and image, in terms of which one goes first, which one comes back, the more deliberate you are about this, the easier it is for you now to project that brand and expose it. And then you begin to build the power of recall, that when people see this color, or when they hear this sound, or when they see this image, there is this association of, oh, that must be MTN, that is why it's wearing yellow. Oh, that must be Glow, that is why this color is green. It takes a lot of deliberate intentionality to get to that point. That will be point number four. Articulate your brand and expose it. Then number five, you must now find the point of connection with your customers. You need to bring that brand alive by reducing it to campaigns, engagements, interactions, communication that can make the customers to start owning that brand. This can take several forms, and the availability of new media channels now even makes that engagement much faster. Many people wonder why organizations invest so much in campaigns and promos and all of that. It is because it gives an opportunity for the consumer to begin to feel and touch and have a sense of ownership of that brand. Until you get to the point where the customer feels like, this is a brand I am happy to identify with, and I'm happy to stand up and say, I am part of this brand, then you have really not done much about brand building. So that is number five. And last but not the least is that it is not a one-off finish, sale, sign, delivered, close shop and go home. No, you need to constantly keep revising and reviewing. What are the competitions doing in the market? What new things are coming in? Some of the things that many years ago were being paid for are now given in the market. Take as an example the small matter of dual SIM. I remember in those days, the first set of dual SIM phones that came on, the two SIMs couldn't work at the same time. Even though you put them in the phone, you must switch from one to another before the other caller can see you. Now, it's gone so advanced that even while you are on call on one line, the other line can provide you with data if you already have it activated. So, the market keeps evolving. You need to keep reviewing and checking and evaluating. And whatever you find must guide you in the process of validating and reinvigorating and breathing new life into your brand. Now, why is it necessary for you to start investing in brand building? I'm sure you already have the answer. If you want an enduring enterprise, and if you want to get to a point where you can charge premium, the only thing that will allow you to do both things I just identified is by building a brand. You can then become a destination brand. You can then become a go-to brand. And I close on this note by asking you a question. When you think of service, which brand comes to your mind? When you think of reliability, which brand comes to your mind? When you think of friendliness, when you think of arrogance, which brand comes to your mind? That is exactly how your brand will be perceived one way or the other, depending on what you do or do not do. The reason why these videos are being put together is to bring these things to your consciousness so that you can get going to do something about them. And then you can enjoy the benefit of entrepreneurship, which is a very, very exciting journey. I'm sorry I have to go now. It's been a very long video as well. Forgive me, but I hope you find it useful. And then next week, we will pick it up from where we've been coming in the organizational life cycle and move to the next phase in that cycle. It's always a pleasure to have you here. Please drop me a note. It's a very big encouragement for me in this journey. Please share this very, very widely in your circle and in your network. I am sure somebody in your circle needs to hear this. I will be glad that you shared it with them. I'm very grateful that you are here once again this week, and I'm sure that you are going to make it a date with me next week. But whatever you do, don't ever forget that Tim Mark is still my name, and all I'm trying to do is what? Make a little difference. Thanks for being here this week, and I'll see you next week. Bye!